Welcome on this short video where we will show how to update your Flash partition in an easy and quick manner. Very often we need to change the device tree file during the Linux BSP adaptation to a custom PCB, for example to change the GPIO or to enable peripheral like SPI or Ethernet. And during this phase, the device tree is changed many times. To avoid to reflash all the SD card with the STM32 cuprammer that takes time, we will see alternative method. We will see how to update and how to see the partition from the Linux PC. And we will have an example with the TFA partition and the U-boot partition, and then we will update the kernel device tree. Okay, let's see how we see the SD card partition from the Linux host PC. For that, we need to use the USB OTG cable that is nearby your USB hub, and you have a default image running on your board, on your PC, on your Linux PC. You can see that we have a console open, and we can interact with the target. We are going to use the U-boot command to see the partition. So first we need to go inside the U-boot shell. So I reboot Linux. I reboot the target. And the objective is to press any key during the boot. Okay, now you see I am in the U-boot shell. So I type this command UMS0 MMC0. MMC0 is for the SD card. On the evaluation board, you have SD card and eMMC. So for the SD card, you will type the same MMC0, and to get access to the eMMC partition, you will have to type 1 instead of 0. So I press this, and you see I see the driver from U-boot starting, and I see all the partitions starting to appear in the virtual machine. So we see that we have different partitions. We have if you look at this, we see the partitions that are accessible from the file system of the Linux machine. So this is a partition that are inside the SD card. And we have also, so this is the bootfs, the rootfs, userfs, so this is some big partition, but we have also the boot partition for the first stage bootloader and the second stage bootloader. If we want to see them, we use another command, which is this one. And we see that we have the first stage bootloader, we have two copies, so two partitions for each copy. And we have the second stage bootloader, which is U-boot in our case. And we find also the other partitions, the bootfs, the rootfs, and so on. So this is the first part. So we see that now from the Linux machine, we can access to the partition that of the SD cards that are on the target. So this is very useful because you don't need to flash everything on the SD card. You can modify some partitions one by one, and this is what we are going to see. To see the partition from the SD card, we put the sequence that we have used. So we start U-boot shell, start this command, and we see the command to see the partition. Okay, so now we are going to update the TFA file. So for that, you see I got to the TFA source file, and I open the DK2DTS file, and I just added this, okay, and I made a recompilation, and now the TFA source file, the TFA device tree is compiled, and we are going to update it. So how to do that? So the best thing is to go into how to cross-compile with the developer package modifying TFA. So you see you can have different sections, how to modify device tree, we will see this after, how to modify U-root and how to modify TFA. So this is a very good page actually. So this is what we have followed just before to see the partition from the Linux machine. And now if you go a little bit down, here we have some command to update just the partition. So you see this is the TFA binary, which is binded with the device tree of TFA also. So the TFA and the source binary, the binary of TFA are together in this file. And so we are going to use dd command with the binary that we want to put inside the SD card. And we have here the partition of the SD card. So here we see that it's SDB1, and we saw that before that SDB1 and SDB2 are for the first stage bootloader copies. We have two here. So we are in the state where we still have U-boot and the partitions that are visible from the machine, and we are going to go inside to update to make this command. So for this command, I prepared it. So here we are in the source file, in the developer package. You see, we have the developer package, and we are actually at the same level as the source file. And just press this command. So here we have the binary, and we are going to update so the SDB2 and make SDB1 also. Okay, and this is it. So now the binary is on the SD card, and if we reset the board and we restart, we see that we see that we are picking up the right binary and the right device tree, and we have the time also. Yeah, we have the build and the time. We can cross check for that. If we do that for the U-boot, it is exactly the same principle. So if you go to, so I reboot the board UMS0, UMC0. So we can see the partition. Now if you go to the source file of U-boot here, we have also compiled the binary of U-boot, which is also binded with the device tree, and we can do that. We can do the same command here. So here we have updated U-boot in the SDB3. So here we still have the same command here. If you go in how modifying U-boot, you have exactly the same procedure how to do that. So here we have SDB3 and we have this command. And the last thing is if you want to update the kernel device tree, for example. So we have an example here on how to modify. And after to recompile it with this command, after we can make the same as we did. So we are going to use, we have an example here. For example, here we are in the kernel device tree file. So it's an hash arm boot DTS folder. And we are in this thing here. So if you put, for example, 4 or 3, change, we can recompile it. So it's very useful, very straightforward. And then after we can make a copy. So here we are using the media mount, the media folder in the file system. Yes, this is the user, dollar user. This is a user, and this is the partition. So here we have the partition available here. This is the bootfs. And in the bootfs, we have the DTB. So this is so we have recompiled the DTB, and now we are going to just make a copy with a sudo to have the right access and this is it. And so this is a little bit different here. When we do that, we need also to eject the partitions, otherwise it will not be updated. So I just I reboot the board, and here we can see now we are going to pick. So here we are picking up the right DTB. So here we have taken the right DTB, so this one, and you can see also that we have here the canal 3 is the partition. So here we have updated the DTB. So this is the end of the lab. Just to recall you what commands were used. So this is for the TFA, reboot, and the kernel with the eject here. And we have also the wiki, which is a very good link actually. Thank you very much.